head, and that series over 10.
That time series?
Yes. And I'm going to use our ownership as I think about it. We started in 1974. And direct to everybody, we're in Fargo and
down this
that
area.
Area that Gordon's covering, that's about our land. I know that we've not had conversion in that time period. We remain at about a 58% what would be classified as uplands, 42% either cypress ponds or hardwoods. And that's the remaining system of that time. Do you think some of that change that you see maybe because there's been harvest?
Yes.
In those areas, but it's grown back. Could it have been that there was a lower reflectivity during that time period? So there wasn't actually a conversion, but it was a change in canopy.
Yes, is the short answer. And I think you can actually see that in the time series. You'll see some of it go away, and then a lot of it come back, because that was a harvest and recovery if you really dive into the data. And this 25% loss that I said as a hard statistic is probably not 25%. It's probably more on the order of 15%, just in my opinion, but that's just an opinion. The other thing that Dr. Kramer is very quick to say, which is kind of cuts, the knife cuts the other direction, is that just because there's hardwood canopy there doesn't mean you still have all the hydrology if there is a channelization structure associated with it or near it. So both things are true. A loss of canopy does not represent a conversion, especially if you can show recovery in the time series. Also, the existence of canopy doesn't indicate healthy hydrology. So you can't use that as a tool by itself to indicate the health or the functionality of the ecosystem. You've got to use it in conjunction with a hydrologic analysis and perhaps even an engineering.